Abdul Ghani Baradar is an Afghan jihadi who was one of the founders of the Taliban in Afghanistan and the deputy of its first leader, Mullah Muhammad Omar. He is known as the best friend of Mullah Muhammad Omar, who nicknamed him Baradar, which means brother. Baradar was arrested in Pakistan by Pakistani intelligence forces in early 2010 and was released on 24 October 2018 at the request of the United States. Since his release, he has played an increasingly influential role within the Afghan Taliban movement. Let's take a quick look at the top 10 amazing facts of Mullah Abdul Ghani Baradar. Number 10. Mullah Abdul Ghani Baradar was born in 1968 in a small village of Urujgan province of Afghanistan. He is a Durrani Pashtun of the Sadojay tribe, which is sub-tribe of Popalzai. He and Muhammad Omar became friends when they were teenagers. Number 9. He took part in combat during the 1980s in the Soviet-Afghan War in Kandahar, serving as Mullah Omar's deputy in a group of Afghan Mujahideen against the Soviet-backed Afghan government. Omar gave him the nickname of Baradar, which means brother, because of their close friendship. Number 8. He later operated a madrasa in Kandahar alongside Omar. According to Western media, Omar and Baradar may be brothers-in-law. In 1994, he was one of four men, including Omar, who founded the Taliban in southern Afghanistan. Number 7. Following the 11 September 2001 attacks, the United States invaded Afghanistan and deposed the Taliban with the help of Afghan forces. Baradar fought against the US-supported Northern Alliance, and according to Newsweek, once he carried Mullah Omar on a motorcycle and drove his old friend to safety in the mountains. In November 2001, as Taliban defenses were crumbling, one story states that a US-linked Afghan force actually seized Baradar and other Taliban figures once, but Pakistani intelligence secured their release. Number 6. The new Afghan government was organized in accordance with the December 2001 Bonn Agreement. Hamid Karzai served as interim leader and later president of Afghanistan. Baradar now found himself fighting international forces and the newly formed Afghan government. Many fellow Taliban commanders were killed over the years following the initial invasion, including Baradar's rival Dadullah, who was killed in Helmand province in 2007. Baradar eventually rose to lead the Shura and became the de facto leader of the Taliban, directing the insurgency from Afghanistan. Number 5. Despite his military activities, Baradar was reported behind several attempts to begin peace talks, specifically in 2004 and 2009, and widely seen as a potentially key part of a negotiated peace deal. Number 4. Mullah Abdul Ghani was arrested by Pakistan's Inter-Services Intelligence, ISI, in late January 2010 in Karachi. The Pakistani security forces were claiming that they had been targeting him since a year. They claimed that the ISI tracked Baradar's cell phone to an area of Karachi and then moved to arrest him. The New York Times concluded that events and motives were still unclear. Some analysts saw Baradar's arrest as a significant shift in Pakistan's position. Others claimed that Pakistan arrested Baradar to stop his negotiations with the Karzai government so that Pakistan would get a seat at the table, because an agreement between the Taliban and the Karzai government could deprive Pakistan of influence in Afghanistan. Number 3. On 25 October 2018, the Taliban confirmed that Pakistan had released Mullah Abdul Ghani. He was subsequently appointed to be the chief of the Taliban's diplomatic office in Doha, Qatar. Washington Special Envoy Zalmay Khalilzad claimed that he was released at the request of the United States. Number 2. In February 2020, Baradar signed the Doha Agreement on the withdrawal of US forces from Afghanistan on behalf of the Taliban. On 17 August 2021, Baradar returned to Afghanistan for the first time since the fall of the original Taliban government in 2001. It was rumored that Baradar will become the president of Afghanistan following the overthrow of the government of Ashraf Ghani by the Taliban in August 2021. Number 1. On 23 August 2021, CI Director William J. Burns held secret meeting in Kabul with Baradar, who returned to Afghanistan from exile in Qatar, to discuss 31st August deadline for a US military withdrawal from Afghanistan. These were the top 10 facts about Mullah Abdul Ghani life. I hope you enjoyed this video. Click on the like button and subscribe to our channel for more upcoming videos.